on Sunday, Ocasio Cortez, she sat down for an interview with Anderson Cooper on CBS's 60 Minutes. Now, during this interview, they spoke about her rapid rise to relevancy. They spoke about how she felt about Donald Trump, and also what she wants to get done while in office. So this clip that we're about to show is about a few of her, quote, radical ideas.
You're talking about zero carbon emissions, no use of fossil fuels within 12 years?
That is the goal. It's ambitious. And
how is that possible? Are you talking about everybody having to drive an electric car?
It's going to require a lot of rapid change that we don't even conceive as possible right now. What is the problem with trying to push our technological capacities to the furthest extent possible?
This would require, though, raising taxes.
There's an element where, yeah, people are going to have to start paying their fair share in taxes.
Do you have a specific on the tax rate?
You know, you look at our tax rates back in the 60s, and when you have a progressive tax rate system, your tax rate, you know, let's say from zero to $75,000 may be 10% or 15%, et cetera. But once you get to like the tippy tops, on your 10 millionth dollar, sometimes you see tax rates as high as 60 or 70%. That doesn't mean all $10 million are taxed at an extremely high rate, but it means that as you climb up this ladder, you should be contributing more.
What you are talking about, just big picture, is a radical agenda compared to the way politics is done right now.
Well, I think that it only has ever been radicals that have changed this country. Abraham Lincoln made the radical decision to sign the Emancipation Proclamation. Franklin Delano Roosevelt made the radical decision to embark on establishing programs like Social Security. That is radical.
Do you call yourself a radical?
Yeah, you know, if that's what radical means, call me a radical.
She kind of hinted at the ridiculousness of calling what she wants to do radical while the president wants to start a space force. She did mention that. She also mentioned the Tax Cut and Jobs Act, too.
Right, right. So, okay, so I'm glad you brought that up. So during this interview, Anderson Cooper was asking her things like, oh, how are you going to pay for it? How are you going to pay for it? And so whenever that question is asked, it's I feel like it's only, and she does too, but I only really hear that question when it comes to these type of individuals, candidates, politicians, like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez or Bernie Sanders, when they're actually being like, okay, we're going to do something for the people. We're going to make sure that every single person in this country is taken care of healthcare-wise, to make sure that education is put first in this country. Like those kind of policies, you're always going to ask, how are you going to pay for it? Meanwhile, the Congressional Budget Office, according to the Congressional Budget Office, just recently, it was announced that the federal deficit jumped up $92 billion in the first quarter, or of the first fiscal quarter of 2019. $92 billion. Compared to 2018, that's a 41% spike. Corporate taxes decreased by 15% or $9 billion.
That's why I don't like the way Anderson Cooper even phrased the question, because he says, what are you talking? He says, your radical agenda, it kind of contrasts how things are currently done. And I'm like, the way he asked it was like, there was nothing wrong with the way things are currently going.
See, money is already being spent right now. It's just being spent in the wrong way that's not to the benefit of the United States and its people. That's what's wrong with the way we're spending money. The deficit is growing. Did we ask how we're going to pay for it? Did the Republicans care about how the tax cuts was going to be paid for? No, they said, you know, we're going to do what's best for the rich people and for these wealthy corporations. We're going to do what's best for them. Sorry, that's what our strategy is. That's what our ideology calls for. We're not going to make any bones about it, and we're not going to be apologizing for it either. But you expect Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and anybody like her to feel some type of way, to feel bad? Like, well, how are you going to pay for it? How are you going to pay for that? You know, there's a budget, right? There's always been a budget. It's just that when Democrats are in control, they're made to feel bad about it, and then they capitulate rightward to the Republicans. Republicans never do that as it relates to the Democrats.